looking live at the mighty Mississippi as she bends into that distinctive crescent curving through the heart of New Orleans. You know, this historic Delta port is the home of the picturesque French Quarter, and nearby, another landmark of American architecture, the Louisiana Superdome. As we zero in on the arena in downtown New Orleans. And outside, 77,000 football fans who paid $125 a ticket are beginning to converge upon the largest indoor stadium in the world to witness the San Francisco 49ers take on the Denver Broncos in a modern-day battle of New Orleans, also known as Super Bowl 24. Well, good afternoon, everyone, and welcome. I'm Brent Musburger, and welcome to our coverage of Super Bowl 24. This is the Vince Lombardi Trophy, the ultimate prize in professional football, and the trophy is named for the late Green Bay Packer coach who won Super Bowls 1 and 2. And today, the San Francisco 49ers are seeking to retain possession of the championship trophy, which they won for the third time a year ago. Now, on the other side of the ledger, the Denver Broncos are also making their fourth Super Bowl appearance, but to date, they've had to return to the Rockies empty-handed. Now, a short time ago, the teams arrived here at the Louisiana Superdome. The first team coming in, the 49ers. Jerry Rice, their splendid wide receiver on the left, and there is their special good luck charm, 18-year-old Alette Cobble, who for the last 10 years has been greeting 49er players as they arrive at the stadium in San Francisco prior to their game. And then it was the Denver Broncos and their quarterback, John Elway, arriving here at the Superdome. They remain one of the biggest underdogs in the history of Super Bowl competition. Well, our NFL Today regulars have been strategically deployed around the Superdome to cover breaking stories. And right now, we want to go down to the San Francisco 49er sideline and check in with our Will McDonough, who has the owner of the 49ers, Eddie DeBartolo, with him. Will?
Thanks, Brent. This is Eddie DeBartolo, and now all his friends will tell you he gets a little bit nervous before games. Okay, I remember, Brent, first Super Bowl, he was in at Detroit. He watched very little of the game, didn't you?
Very little.
About 10 minutes worth. What did you do during the game?
Oh, I paced around a little bit. The first one was really difficult. I mean, we walked around the Silver Dome. I ended up in the press box. And I'm not exactly 6'2", and I got behind people, and I couldn't even see over their heads. So I was looking at the monitor. I watched most of the end of the game on monitor.
Okay, you told me while we're waiting, you really didn't get much sleep last night.
I got up pretty early. I went to bed about 11:45, and I got up about 2:40.
What'd you do the rest of the night?
Walked around the city. We just made sure everything was okay. It was dark, and it was sort of barren.
Yeah. Eddie, thanks very much for taking the time. Now let's go over to Irv Cross.
Thanks, Will. You know, over on the Denver Broncos sideline, their major concern right now are two key injuries, two outstanding offensive players. Rookie sensation Bobby Humphrey, who rushed for over 1,100 yards this year, even though he's had 2 weeks to mend, comes into the game with two cracked ribs. He'll be playing with a flak jacket with special padding, which should protect that rib area pretty well. I saw him earlier today, and he told me he hadn't had any problem at all running with the flak jacket, and he feels pretty good about it. As a matter of fact, earlier this week in practice, he took a couple of hits to the rib cage. Didn't bother him at all. But the injury they're most concerned about is the starting tight end, Clarence Kay. He's a great pass blocker and run blocker, rather. And without him in the lineup, it's going to really affect their overall ability to run the ball today. Clarence Kay is an outstanding run blocker. He has a deep muscle pull in his side right now that affects his ability to push off. So the Broncos find themselves coming into this game today facing the defending world champions with two of their key players on offense, particularly in the running game, on the mend. Let's go to Dick Butkus.
Thanks, Will. Thanks, Irv. I'm out here in the stadium here outside. We got a little look of New Orleans people right here. We've got some twins back there. We've got Gypsy Boots here from San Francisco. Hey, looks like we got the Denver Sheriff back here. We've also had some real fans here with the beer and hot dogs. Clear over there is the white tent with the corporate executives having their Oysters Rockefeller and things like that. I met a guy, Barry Ross. He came all the way from Australia. Another fella came from Scotland. And two people from Cleveland spent $1,350 for their tickets. About the only thing that's free, Brent, is this. I hope I can get back in the stadium.
Dick, I'll try to send your credential down. And right now, let me take a moment now to preview this afternoon's TV lineup for you. Kickoff time is scheduled for just a little over 2 hours from now, and in the interim, we're going to be setting the stage for Super Bowl 24. We've structured the pregame program around four major themes, and here are some of the folks you're going to be hearing from as the Super Bowl today unfolds.
I'm Jerry Bradshaw, and I'll tell you what I really think about John Elway, and along with my friends Kenny Stabler, Dan Fouts, we'll take a special look back at football in the 80s.
Hi, I'm John Madden. Pat Summerall and I have been with both the teams all week. And later on, we're going to talk about some injuries to key players and the effect that that will have on the game plan. But you know, the players and the game plan, that's not the only preparation going on for Super Bowl.
I'm Pat O'Brien in Monongahela, Pennsylvania, and we'll show you how they're enjoying Super Bowl 24 in the cradle of quarterbacks, the hometown of Joe Montana. And Brent, we will join you live with that story in our final segment called The Game.
All right, Pat, and when we come back now, we're going to introduce our first theme, the season, with a look at the brightest and the best in the NFL when the Super Bowl today continues live from New Orleans here on CBS.
The Super Bowl today, live from New Orleans, is sponsored by AT&T, the right choice. Budweiser, the king of beers. Remember, know when to say when. And by Delta Airlines. We love to fly, and it shows.
It weighs 1 millionth of an ounce. Yet it can take a 2,000-pound car and blow it right off the road. That's why you should drive the new four-wheel drive Subaru Legacy. Think of it as a five-passenger snowmobile.
The best-laid plans of beagles and men often go astray. Check with your MetLife rep to make sure you have the right kind of insurance. Get Met. It pays.
This is really weird. I have to shampoo a lot. And every time I do, my hair gets wet, but my scalp gets dry. It's tight and itchy. The more I shampoo, the drier it can get. I can't stop shampooing, but I can use this. New dry scalp shampoo from Head & Shoulders. Made a different way, so it doesn't dry out your scalp like those other guys can. Try Head & Shoulders new dry scalp shampoo. It'll help wipe out dry scalp.
Imagine you were building a town. One company can supply you with almost any kind of truck to do almost any kind of job. That company is Ryder. We're more than yellow trucks. We help build towns, business by business, family by family, dream by dream. Ryder, we're there at every turn.
Oh, welcome back to the Super Bowl in New Orleans. You know, this is the seventh time that the Super Bowl has been in the city, and the AFC and the NFC have split the first six, three victories apiece. Now, for the San Francisco 49ers and the Denver Broncos, being here today is the reward for months of hard work and preparation. To begin our special retrospective of the season, let's roll back the clock to a not-so-distant time when the hopes of every football fan and player were fresh and shiny.
September. And in the golden light of autumn, 28 teams embarked upon a five-month journey. Destination, New Orleans, the Super Bowl.
When you climb a mountain, you take one step at a time. Don't go looking at the top. You end up slipping on your...
So what? They've been in the Super Bowl. So what, Redskins? It's time to go out and kick some...
I want to see what they got up front. I want to block. I want to handle them.
All we need is a win. On three. One, two, three.
Win!
Yes, sir.
Weeks of regular season action, rising to a frenzied crescendo. The brutal intensity of combat, punctuated by precious moments of comic relief. Some stories were sad and personal. Others were tragic and communal, involving the massive trauma of an entire region. And for Green Bay's long-suffering fans, some magical relief.
Mikowski with the snap, looking, now stepping up, on the run. He's going to have to throw in the end zone. Throw it down, and touchdown! Sterling Sharp, and what a throw by Mikowski!
The Kansas City Chiefs saw Christian Okoye develop into a Nigerian nightmare for opposing defenders.
He's going to wear your out! He's going to wear your out, baby! He's going to wear your out!
Chiefs handoff, Okoye up the middle to the five. Touchdown, Okoye. Oh, mercy.
Boy, he is too big and too fast to be playing running back in the NFL.
Are you okay?
Yeah.
100%?
Yeah.
Good.
Elsewhere, head coaches felt the pressure cooker reach the boiling point. For some, the frustration simply simmered over.
And am I aggravated? Yes, I'm aggravated because I don't remember feeling this bad in 1982 when I knew we couldn't play football. Now, I don't know if we're capable of winning another football game. I don't think we are at this point. This football team is in disarray and we are not very good.
And I'm promising you right now that you don't know when it's good or bad. You really don't know because you don't know what we're trying to do. You guys don't look at the films. You don't know what happened. You really don't know. You think you know, but you don't know. And you never will.
We get down there, and it was a dumb play by Anderson. I love Anderson. But it was a dumb play when his foot was, shoe was coming off, up to the line screen. We were hollering take timeout. We had a trap play called, and his shoe comes off.
Art Shell became the NFL's first black head coach of the modern era. And he watched as Bo did it.
Trying to sweep the left side. Turns it up to the 10, 15, up the left side to 20. He's at the 30. Maybe nobody will get him. 50, 40.
Detroit's Barry Sanders was a runaway rookie of the year. While in Chicago, the Butler did it. And last but not least, Steve Largent bid farewell, but not before catching a spot in Pro Football's Hall of Fame.
Little pump fake now, looks close to the end zone.
There it is!
Touchdown Seahawks, number 100!
And even for those teams who ultimately fell by the wayside, oh, what a journey it was!
And what a journey for that man, Vance Johnson, the leading wide receiver of the Denver Broncos, out here about 2 hours prior to kickoff, along with teammate Mark Jackson. And these are two of the wideouts who figure to be extremely active for John Elway here this afternoon. And we'll continue live with our countdown to Super Bowl 24 on CBS in just a moment.
Hold your small business back. Now AT&T can set you free with the first cordless phone specifically designed for business, the multi-line Merlin Cordless. It works with AT&T small business phone systems, so you don't have to lose any quality to gain your freedom. Set your business free. Call 1-800-MERLIN-ATT for the new Merlin Cordless.
How fast does Dristan nasal spray start to work?
Faster than Dolly can pick up a $5 tip.
Dristan spray pump works fast to relieve congestion, even sinus pressure. For relief...
Faster than tumbleweed in a tornado.
Dristan nasal spray. It's faster than...
When does a good quarterback make a great receiver? When someone who's been drinking passes him their car keys. Nice pass. If you've been drinking, pass your car keys to someone who hasn't.
Know when to say when. A reminder from Budweiser.
Sometimes I dream I'm in Italy, driving this incredible sports car. And my boss is there. He says,
"We need a ride to the shareholders meeting."
Now, here's where it gets weird. The sports car has four doors. I mean, there's no such thing as a four-door sports car. It's just a dream, right?
no better example of people helping people, what I call a point of light, than NFL Charities and the man who started it all, former Commissioner Pete Rozelle. Pete, to you, for your 29 years of service, and to NFL Charities for your fight against drugs, and for the millions you've raised for groups like the United Way, please accept this special commendation.
Thank you, Mr. President, for me and for NFL. I'm deeply honored.
It was truly a great honor to be chosen as the most valuable player in Super Bowl 23. But I have come to know that there are a lot of people who are the most valuable players in their community. Here in San Francisco, there's a critical need for professional daycare services. And for all of you who give to the United Way, you are the MVPs, the most valuable people in San Francisco. The United Way, it brings out the best in all of us.
This message furnished by the National Football League.
Well, there is a mecca for jazz enthusiasts around the world. So many of them have made pilgrimages to Preservation Hall to listen to that old, authentic Dixieland jazz. Special chemistry to make music like this on the football field. And as Dick Butkus shows us, in football, you also need to find just the right formula if you want to reach the playoffs.
47!
Many experts thought that powerful defenses would carry the Bills and the Vikings to the Super Bowl. The talented Vikings won the NFC Central, but a chaotic coaching situation under Jerry Burns often led to inconsistency.
Where the hell's the ball?
On the floor.
Okay, shut the f*** up a minute.
While Viking coaches fought with their players, Bills coaches fought among themselves, and dissension eventually followed. Buffalo won its division, but the Bills never achieved the kind of team spirit that Bill Parcells instilled in his Giants.
Hey, fellas, this is what you work all offseason for. This is why you lift all them weights. This is why you do all that.
I couldn't score that.
Parcells blended age with youth, but it was defense that took a team in transition to the top of the NFC East.
Watch the crowd be quiet. He's having trouble having his men hear his signals. Fourth down at the goal line. About a foot to go. Elway, hands off. They dive. Stop! The Giants throw through Gary Reasons.
Great play by Gary Reasons.
Patience marked the coaching of Chuck Knoll, who was able to laugh off an opening day 51-0 loss and lead his Cinderella Steelers to a wild card berth. Adjustments by John Robinson turned the once run-happy Rams into an explosive aerial machine.
Everett looking to pass. Throws into the end zone. It is completed. He's in. Touchdown.
Denver's Dan Reeves changed his defensive thinking, bringing in Wade Phillips to transform the Broncos from small and smart to big, mean, and intimidating. Bud Carson, a longtime NFL defensive coordinator known for his aggressive ways, took over a good Browns team and made it better with bold and daring moves.
Snaps clean. The kick is no. Hagel throws to Waiters for a touchdown. They fake the field goal, and the Browns win it in overtime.
Then there was George Seifert. Bill Walsh's successor faithfully adhered to the system he inherited. His quarterback, Joe Montana, had the greatest season of his career as San Francisco racked up an NFL-high 14 victories. In the divisional playoffs, the 49ers kept right on rolling. easily eliminating the confused and frustrated Minnesota Vikings.
Sander drops back to throw. Goes across the middle. It is complete to Wright. Wright to the 45. He's to the 50. He breaks through. He's down to the 30. He's down to the 20. He's to the 10. Oh, touchdown 49ers.
He peeled out and he came up the field, man, and he peeled me right in, man. I never even saw him. I never saw again.
We got some big coming back to do, guys. Let's do it.
Against Cleveland, the Bills put aside their season-long personal disputes. But in the game's final desperate seconds, their lack of teamwork came back to haunt them.
Kelly waiting. Standing at the 15-yard line. Wideouts left and right. Dropping back. In the pocket. Looking. Throws. Touchdown. End zone. No! Oh, it was dropped. It was dropped in the end zone.
For the Steelers, midnight struck early.
Calling up still a Cinderella team. We still got our glass slippers intact.
Third and goal at the one. No motion. Handoff. Brad Stein scores!
Against the Giants, John Robinson's aggressive offensive philosophy paid off in overtime.
Wide left, Flipper wide right. First and 15 of the Giants 30. Back to throw. Everett sets. Fires up the right side for Flipper Anderson. Caught for the touchdown on the Rams.
From 28 teams, four survivors. Each with a winning chemistry.
Go, tell me. Good luck,
on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Give us our trespasses.
We give those our trespasses. Lead us out of temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, power, and glory forever.
Well, some very moving scenes from inside the locker room to some of the most successful NFL teams of this season. And you are looking at an overhead view of the Louisiana Superdome and now outside the Denver Broncos Hotel, where their fans, of course, will begin flocking over to the dome here. We expect a crowd in excess of 77,000. Some of the early arrivees here today. Getting ready to enjoy Super Bowl 24 between their beloved Broncos or 49ers. And we'll continue live from New Orleans in just a moment.
There is no sound so unique as the human voice. Soon, it will bring you voice-activated calling on the all-fiber optic network of U.S. Sprint.
Chris Stanford.
A system that recognizes your voice.
Call home.
And dials numbers.
Hello, darling.
Just by asking. Such is the power of the human voice. The new voice-activated calling card. Only from U.S. Sprint.
Every evening, we pack 700,000 passengers onto our planes. No drinks are served, no meals are prepared. Yet our customers love our service, like our UPS Next Day Air letter. Guaranteed overnight delivery to any address coast to coast. And at prices far less than other companies charge, no one seems to mind that there's no in-flight movie.
If your feathers have been ruffled by downdrafts in the market, get on board something big, safe, and secure. GetNet. It pays.
I've tried it. Now I believe it. Denerex Tingles tells me it's doing more. Head and shoulders, no tingle.
Both have dandruff medicine, but Denerex adds both an extra anti-itch medicine and conditioner, too.
Goodbye, head and shoulders. Hello, Denerex.
She loved her husband and her
country.
You're a spy for the Russians.
Which one would she choose? Family of Spies, beginning next Sunday.
Well, outside the Louisiana Superdome, look, you can see the reflection of the helicopter there on the top of the dome. So the folks beginning to come in, and because we play this game under a roof, obviously, that's an artificial carpet down there. And the San Francisco 49ers have been tremendous on this surface over the last 2 years. They are 8-0, including a record of 5-0 this year. And Joe Montana has had four passes this season alone, scoring passes in excess of 50 yards as Vance Johnson and the rest of the Broncos continue getting ready. But what is it about the Niners and the Broncos that has brought them and not other teams here to the Super Bowl? To be sure, an abundance of talent, but there is much more to the makings of these champions.
All right, now. Everybody knows what's in front of us. Dre, you've been here. A lot of those people, Chubb, you and Holmes. Gotta work your life for this. That's the doorstep.
We're gonna establish a level of play that is great, and we're gonna maintain it throughout this whole game.
Hey, we've done it before. We gotta do it again.
It ain't no tomorrow.
It ain't no tomorrow.
Hey, what do we come here to do? Get the Super Bowl.
Ever visited an NFL training camp during those dog days of July and August, you certainly appreciate even more that grueling mental and physical regimen the players subject themselves to. all to the service of really one overriding goal, which has brought us together here, and that's the Super Bowl. And we come back now, we're going to hear from today's head coaches, George Seifert of the 49ers and Dan Reeves of the Broncos, both of whom are seeking their first Super Bowl victories at the helm. And we'll continue live in just a moment.
American Express brings a world of unsurpassed service to all our card members. The power to spend with no preset limits. Protection for the things you buy. Access to cash when you're far from home. Around the corner or around the world, American Express is always there to give every card member our best personal service. Membership has its privileges.
It's powerful. A new kind of protection. Speed Stick Deodorant Sport Talc. Made just for a man. New Speed Stick Sport Talc. Powerful all-day protection.
The four-wheel drive Subaru has always gotten the U.S. ski team to their events early. Yet at the 89 World Championships, the other countries got there first. How'd they do it? We lent them each a Subaru.
Oh, the phone cords that bind, that hold your small business back. Now AT&T can set you free with the first cordless phone specifically designed for business, the multi-line Merlin Cordless. It works with AT&T small business phone systems, so you don't have to lose any quality to gain your freedom. Set your business free. Call 1-800-MERLIN-ATT for the new Merlin Cordless.
Your butt, Snoopy.
Good.
Next weekend on CBS Sports.
Well, looking down on New Orleans from the MetLife blimp, hovering at 1,000 feet overhead. And yeah, you know, here in the home of the Mardi Gras, folks do indeed love a parade. And down there in the midst of all of that marching is the Denver Dixie Parade. And let's go down live to our Leslie Visser. Leslie?
Brent, New Orleans has always had a tradition of parades. You mentioned that monument to merriment, the Mardi Gras. Well, this is something different. More than 1,000 Bronco fans are here marching down to the Superdome. I'm here with Andre Smith, wife of All-Pro safety Dennis Smith. Andre, the Broncos have a lot of supporters here, but not many around the country.
I feel we're going to win this time. God gave us a fourth time to get in the Super Bowl, and I just feel this time we're going to take it.
Andre, your husband, of course, roomed with Ronnie Lott at USC in college, and they've remained close friends. Did they get together this week?
Actually, they did an interview together by satellite, but they didn't actually hang out together. I think they called. Dennis called his hotel room when he wasn't there and just left a message that he cared and hope he had a good game, but I don't think they really want to hang out together too much.
Well, we'll see what they both have in store. Back to you, Brent.
All right, Leslie.
Yeah.
You know, nobody has more Super Bowl experience than Dan Reeves, who has played or coached in 8 Super Bowls, and he has the evidence to prove it. And just a short while ago, the NFL's Lord of the Rings arrived here at the Superdome, and Irv spoke with him.
I'm in front of the Denver Broncos locker room with head coach Dan Reeves. Dan, I know you as a tremendous competitor. You just kind of burn inside. And I know you've heard many, many times, you know, the third Super Bowl for Dan Reeves. If he should lose it, you know, it'll be the fourth loss to the Broncos. Do you feel pressure coming in because of that?
Well, I think there's pressure every time you tee it up. You know, when you walk on the field, there's pressure. This football team has played extremely well all year. We realize that there's pressure. We're one step away from being world champions. Not many people have that opportunity. And so there's pressure, regardless of what people say, well, we're the underdogs and there's no pressure. There's pressure there. We realize that. But also there's a tremendous challenge in front of us. And that challenge, I think, is something that all of us are looking forward to.
Dan, 2 key injuries I know you're concerned about, the running back Bobby Humphrey and Clarence Kay, your tight end. Well, how are they going to be today?
Well, we really won't know until the game starts. There's no way we could simulate how Ronnie Lott's going to hit Bobby Humphrey in practice. So until he takes a shot and see how he reacts once he gets hit, falls on the ground in a pileup because, your ribs get compressed during that time. We really won't know. Clarence Kay is the same way. We'll look at him in pregame warm-up, see how he does, because we had to make a decision an hour and 45 minutes before the game as to who we would have activated. Clarence Kay will be activated, and how much he plays is going to be determined by how well he warms up.
A true Southern gentleman, Dan Reeves. And you know, in a rite of passage that coincided with Super Bowl week, George Seifert, in one sense, left the ranks of the 49ers. He turned 50. And Will McDonough, who visited with San Francisco's rookie head coach at his hotel yesterday, asked him about how difficult it was to deal with the distractions of Super Bowl week.
It's been a little more distracting, actually, than a normal situation or last year when I was a defensive coordinator. But I believe that I'm used to that from the standpoint of what's taking place throughout the entire season. The staff, we're used to working with one another, and each coach knows his responsibility, each of the players do. So I feel comfortable with the way it's gone.
With the way your team has been built up the last couple of weeks, are you worried at all about them being overconfident?
The only time it's really talked about is when we're visiting with the media. Within the team itself, it's not talked about. And all we have to do is look at the film of the defense that we're going to be facing, of the offense that we're going to be facing, of the different personnel. And that tends to for our team to focus. That causes our team to focus. Plus the fact that we really concentrate on ourselves as much as any one thing, and maybe even in many respects more than the other team. We concentrate on what we do. And that in itself doesn't allow you to think about too many other things or what the point spread might be.
The last chance you have to talk to the players, what are you going to talk to them about?
Well, there's some, I guess I would say they're personal things and personal things to this club. It's a family, and there are traditional things that we talk about just, you know, talk about the oneness of the club generally.
And he's done a great job of replacing Bill Walsh. And you can see outside the fans beginning to flock toward the Superdome. One of the nice aspects of having a Superdome here in New Orleans is how close the hotels and everything is, really, to the Louisiana Superdome. You can just put on your Mardi Gras costume and kind of march on over for football games. Still ahead of us, we're going to be hearing from three of the greatest quarterbacks to play in the National Football League. There they are, Terry Bradshaw, Kenny Stabler, and Dan Fouts. And we'll continue live in just a moment.
Who's got the marketing plan?
I do.
Sales forecast?
Right here.
Presentation boards?
Murphy's got them.
Where's Murphy?
This is the final boarding call for Delta Flight.
Maddie Klein knows careers are right in Delta Flight.
Mr. Murphy?
Yes. Yeah. Better go.
Nobody told me you had a cast.
Nobody knew.
Maybe that's why more business people fly Delta than ever before.
Mr. Murphy, you have a nice trip.
Thanks. Already had one.
Delta, we love to fly, and it shows.
The Volvo 240 has built a reputation for surviving accidents. And we at Subaru have always been impressed by that. So we gave the new Subaru Legacy Wagon unibody construction, like the Volvo 240. But unlike the 240, the Subaru Legacy is available with full-time four-wheel drive and anti-lock brakes. Because the best way to survive an accident is not to get into one.
Gillette announces a razor that can sense the individual needs of your face. Introducing the extraordinary Gillette Sensor Shaving System. Sensor blades are mounted on responsive springs to continuously sense and adjust to your face for the best shave a man can get. Closer, smoother, safer. New Gillette Sensor.
You never know where history will unfold, but you always know where to turn. The CBS Evening News with Dan Rather. You always know when it's CBS News.
Well, looking at the 80s, it certainly was a decade dominated by quarterbacks.
Throwing in the end zone. Caught it. Dwight Clark. A
I'm the pucky QB known as McMahon. When I hit the turf, I've got no plan. I just throw my body all over the field. I can't dance, but I can throw the field.
Perry in motion to the near side. McMahon fakes the
He's
hand.
He's open!
Fires the right side.
Oh, there he goes!
And Elway wants to throw. Fires over the middle. Rolling catch for a touchdown by Jackson.
Back to throw, Montana. Steps up, throws.
Great moments authored by quarterbacks, and with us three of the finest to play the game, Terry Bradshaw, and to my right, Kenny Stabler, Dan Fouts. Gentlemen, why was the 80s, why were the 80s so dominated by you quarterbacks?
I think, Brett, probably one of the real keys that really turned the 80s into such an exciting period, decade for the quarterbacks was something that happened late in the 70s, 78, somewhere along in there, where they changed the rules for jamming the receivers, which at the time we were playing a lot of bump and run, where the corners would come up and jam a receiver and ride him down. The quarterback would set up, wait, get sacked, wait, and finally get rid of the ball. And then all of a sudden they said, well, we're going to open up passing, and the way to do that was take away the jam after 5 yards, no touching. You know, you couldn't put your hands on him. And the receivers are running free through the secondary. In the 80s, when that really caught off with all these quarterbacks, man, you saw the passing game just where you were throwing 150 yards a game, what, 250, yeah. 280. Man, if you didn't throw for 280 yards, you had a bad day.
I think liberalizing the blocking rules for the offensive lineman has given the quarterbacks much more time. I think the quarterbacks are seeing more man-to-man coverage than they ever have. The pressure from the outside linebackers, bringing everybody after the quarterback, dictates playing a man-to-man type coverage. And as a result, you're going to see the quarterbacks throwing for higher percentages.
And we're seeing a lot better coaching of quarterbacks. And when I was playing with Don Coryell, the biggest thing he wanted to say is that, listen, why run the ball for 3 yards in a cloud of dust when we could throw it for 6 or 10 on every down? And so the big thing that he stressed, and I think a lot of coaches have carried on, is that you can be successful throwing the ball.
Well, you know, gentlemen, so much has been made of how cool and how loose Joe Montana is on the field. There's a reason. And this week, Irv picked up on a whole new angle on Joe.
Okay, look down a little, Joe, too.
What has this done for you, you think?
Well, I think the best thing does is that your bones from the game are always, you know, it's a it's a contact game, and you know you're going to get out of alignment all the time. And I think it not only helps you feel better, but it helps the healing process.
Joe, how does this make you feel?
You have a better feeling throughout your whole body, but also it helps you get rid of your injuries quicker, and so you feel better when you go on the field from two different points of view.
Plus, help you with his headaches. You have headaches?
Oh, yeah. I get tension headaches that are unbelievable, and it really
relieves all the stress and pressure off the nerves.
Wait a minute.
Cool Joe Montana has tension headaches?
It's the kids.
Chiropractor's coming right up here to deal with us, but Dan, what about Joe Montana? Could you guys have fit into this 49ers system? Could you have been successful in?
Well, the system that I played in is very similar. It's a rhythm type of thing. You get back, you get rid of the ball, you have a progression of reads. The thing that I admire so much about Montana is his composure in the pocket and his courage, and as you've seen, his cool. He just is one guy that doesn't get flustered by interceptions or sacks.
His decision-making process is the thing that I like. When Joe gets back there, gets set, the ball is gone very quickly, doesn't give anybody a chance to get to him, and the decision that he makes seems to always be the right one.
I don't know. I know for a fact that I could have never played in his system because I was the guy that had such a strong arm that I had a tendency and felt safer if I could see the receiver come open. I could beat the defense, you know, with the strong arm. So I don't think that I could have played in Montana's system. But the one thing I marvel about Montana is pretty much all of the combination, but the fact that when the game is on the line, the bigger the game, he raises his level of excellence to a level that no one, I think, can approach in today's football.
Dan, you said cool. You guys ever get scared when you're on a field with big guys coming in?
You really don't have time to get scared because so many things are happening. You're scared right now before the game, all the things you're going to have to worry about, and then once in a while you look at yourself in the mirror and go, at least I did. I'm the behind the entire football field, and I got to stand out there in the middle of that hurricane.
Your concentration level is someplace else. It's down the field. It's thinking about what you've done in the past, what you're going to do the next series, and you're not thinking in terms of being scared.
You know, he has so much speed, Terry. Now, you had great speed with Swan and Stallworth. When you take a look at what Joe has done on artificial turf, they're 5-0, and he's got 4 touchdowns in excess of 50 yards. Will that speed be a huge factor for him here?
A lot of people say no, but I really believe it's kind of like the theory of working out on the beach or putting on the lead boots and running, and then all of a sudden you take those boots off and you go out, and all of a sudden you really are faster. And I think with the 4 quick receivers that the 49ers use and the quick offense, this is a very 1-2-3, get the ball away, 5 steps, get the ball away. And now you get on this turf, which is a fast track. I think that really is an asset, a benefit, a plus for the 49ers.
Okay. No advantage, no disadvantage. It'll help both teams with their speed.
All right. Next up, we're going to focus our attention on Montana's counterpart, John Elway, when the Super Bowl today continues live from New Orleans after this word from your local stations.
It's Valerie Harper. She's the talk of the town on Monday night.
Ken, you incredible hunk. I want you naked on the desk.
City premieres Monday after Major Dad.
This is CBS.
We got the jump, jump, jump. Toyota gets you in gear. We got the jump.
Right now, you can get a super deal on every car in the Toyota lineup. Plus, save up to almost $1,000 on option packages on Corolla, one of 5 Toyotas just named the Consumer's Digest Best Buy. So come on, tackle a Toyota.
Oh, we got the jump! Oh, the competition, yeah! We got the jump!
When do you drink America's favorite German beer?
Every once in a while, or twice in a while, or 3 times.
Beck's, the number 1 imported German beer.
Am I missing something? Buy your own phone system, here's what you get. It breaks, you have to fix it. Outgrow it, you have to replace it. But here's what you get with Pacific Bell Centrix. The whole system's at Pacific Bell, not at your office. They maintain it 24 hours every day. All you do is call Pacific Bell and say, plug me in. Pacific Bell, we're making things easier.
Some people call it guerrilla television, gonzo television, tabloid television. This show is rampant anarchy. When you peel away the layers of the story, when it comes down to its one-on-one, it comes down to the heartbeat of the story, that's when it gets real good.
Guts TV, weekdays at 7.
49ers post-game report, Sunday after the Super Bowl.
The street artists at work here. Over in the French Quarter in New Orleans. Wait a minute there. I'm sure those will go for a premium price, right, folks? Well, you know, if Joe Montana is the man to beat today, then certainly John Elway is the man with most to prove. He's lost in 2 Super Bowls already in the 80s, and his Broncos have been installed as heavy underdogs here today. And Dan Fouts asked him about that.
Everybody's excited about the chance, and I think that everyone's feeling like we're not getting much respect, and the 49ers are getting all the respect. So I think that it's added a little bit of fuel to the fire.
What type of matchups are you looking for in this game?
They do some different things in the secondary. They don't do a lot of different things, but some things we're not used to, and we're going to try to put the tight end in the backfield and move him around and try to get the coverage that we want. We can do that by movement, and because they go to the same adjustment every time we move the tight end. So we're going to go to that and try to get singled up outside and really throw off the strong safety.
John, 21 years ago, Joe Namath predicted a victory. Will you?
I really feel good about our chances because I think that we feel we're a pretty good football team, and I think that defensively we match up well with their offense, and I think offensively we can move the football on them. So I definitely feel like not a lot of other people in that. Yeah, we can beat these guys. If we go out and play our type of football, there's no question in my mind we can beat them.
Kenny, your feeling about Elway as a quarterback?
I think there's a great deal of pressure on him, Brent, to get the monkey off his back, so to speak. And certainly you don't label him as a loser because he loses this game 3 times by any means. You don't get there as a loser. But before he'll be recognized as one of the great ones, along with Terry and all the people that have been involved in the Super Bowl, he's going to have to win one.
Yeah, the thing, Brent, is that having never played in the Super Bowl, I think John Elway
has accomplished a great deal to get here three times. And for him to get tagged as a loser isn't fair because it's a team sport and he has had an outstanding career.
I have deliberately saved Terry Bradshaw.
Yeah, I kind of felt you had.
Yeah, a couple of words came up this week, one inconsistent, the other coddled by the coaching staff. Now, Dan had an opportunity to ask John Elway exactly what he felt about your comments.
Well, you know, and Terry's been a guy that's kind of been on my back since I've been in the league, and he's always had these different things to say, and, you know, here's a guy that talks out of school as far as I'm concerned. He doesn't know what the situation is Denver with me, and a guy that pops his mouth off. So, you know, I'm not one of those guys that likes to cause controversy, and he is, and for that, I have no respect for him.
That's fine. I would expect those type of remarks from someone that, in a game like this, when someone would say or challenge you a little bit, maybe challenge your manhood, or maybe attack the very principles of what you try to accomplish. And in a lot of cases, John is right. But on the other side of that, you have to understand that when I came in here and the media, when they got to me, the questions were asked of me, is he a great quarterback? In 1989, I said, there's only one. Then the other questions about the cuddling, said, sure. But the thing I was saying, you've got to become emotionally and mentally stronger. You can't let anyone know that you have a kink in your armor. These weren't criticisms of John. These were questions placed at me, and they got turned around the other way, which is fine. I'll stand by it. I don't have any problem with that at all. I think it's kind of good.
You know, Terry's always had great mobility, hasn't he?
He danced pretty good, didn't he, Kenny?
His reply was, stick it in your ear, was it?
Well, I wish I had a stick it in my ear, but I think that's, you know, it's unfortunate that it got like it did, but what am I going to apologize? I'm not going to do that because I would be like admitting I was wrong. I was just answering the question honestly. It's just unfortunate that I didn't think that possibly he was a great quarterback.
Gentlemen, no discussion really about the NFL in the 80s is complete without touching on the decade's most controversial innovation, instant replay. Now, the ongoing uproar got our Curry Kirkpatrick thinking, and from his daydreaming, he emerged with a satirical journey through the looking glass.
With all the controversy over instant replay, wouldn't it be great if life's everyday disputes could be settled the same way they are in pro football? Oh, I'm late. I got to get to the game. Hey, I was here first.
Hey, pal, it's my cab. What are you going to do about it?
Here's what I'm going to do about it. We're going to go to the instant replay.
This view from the blimp clearly shows I was way ahead of this guy. But now let's check the reverse angle. See? Right there. Conclusive evidence. A flagrant injustice.
Adios, buddy!
Hey, it's obvious I beat that clown. It's situations like this that make people wonder, what is that guy doing up there in the replay booth?
Montana deep, Jerry Rice wide open. Say goodnight. It's a touchdown.
Come on, ref, he dropped the ball. You're killing us. Go back to your other job. You shut up. That's why we have instant replay. And now we're going to my guy up in the booth.
Roy, it sure is hot in here today.
Pee-wee, my man. Pee-wee's playoffs. Lay it on me, Pee-wee. Oh, no, not now. This is my favorite part.
Oh. Hello, hello.
Yeah, what about it? Does Rice score?
What? Rice? Don't give me Rice. I ordered pizza.
Come on and kick it, Coker, before they figure out what's going on. Come on, give me a break. What are you doing up there?
Oh, I can't really tell here. Like a virgin. Oh, I feel strongly both ways.
Will this ever be resolved? Let's go to the French Quarter.
Well, we're still down here waiting for the call. Can you believe it's taken this long?
Oh, good, finally. Oh, no. Yeah. What, Bill? I thought you were going to pay the light bill. After further review, the play stands as called. Touchdown, 49ers.
No way, that's a pathetic call. As you can plainly see, the life of a replay official is no day at the beach. Hey, I'll take that last one.
Hey, forget this guy. I was here first. Would you get out of the way?
Oh, come on. Wasn't I here first again? Let's go to the tape.
Upon further review, I'm still Curry Kirkpatrick, CBS Sports.
Well, we can assure you that things are going to be a lot more professional in the replay. Gentlemen, thank you very much for joining us this afternoon. Enjoy the game. Coming up next now, a man with a very special interest in today's game, the owner of the Denver Broncos, Pat Bowlen. And we continue live on CBS.
It's simple. The bottom line is, when you drink, don't just use your mouth, use your whole head. No joke. Be a responsible drinker. Please, know when to say when.
A reminder from Budweiser.
It's powerful. A new kind of protection. Speed Stick Deodorant Sport Talc. Made just for a man. New Speed Stick Sport Talc. Powerful all-day protection.
In Paris, they lined up in the streets. In Rome, it was standing room only. In L.A. and New York, his concert sold out in an hour. So if you want to see Paul McCartney and his new band, get in line early and get out your Visa card. Because a concert like this doesn't take place every day, and it doesn't take American Express. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
Toyota's 1990 4x4. Park it anywhere.
I love what you do for me, Toyota.
Billions of dollars in payroll, thousands of jobs at stake. The Pentagon hit list could shut down our military installations. Our Bay Area bases in real danger of shutting down. The story, Monday, on Eyewitness News at 5.
Tonight, it's a countdown to Super Bowl Sunday on KPIX 5. 7 o'clock, the John Madden Super Bowl Special with Channel 5's own Wayne Walker. 9 o'clock, Super Bowl Saturday Night from New Orleans. Don Johnson hosts a star-studded evening of comedy and jazz. 11 o'clock, Eyewitness News Nightcast with up-to-the-minute news on the eve of Super Bowl Sunday. That's all tonight, starting at 7 on KPIX 5, your Bay Area sports station.
Welcome back to the 7th Super Bowl to visit the city of New Orleans. Projected total expenditures by visitors for this game, $60 to $65 million. That's why these cities thirst after a Super Bowl. The only problem with the buildup for this game, of course, was the fact that hotel rooms were not available, that a lot of scalpers had gotten their hands on them. And if the Super Bowl and when the Super Bowl returns to this city, they hope to have that corrected. The crowd now beginning to file in. We'll have a throng in excess of 77,000 here today. Each ticket scaled at $125. So welcome back to the Superdome. And just a short time ago, several members of the San Francisco 49ers stepped out of their locker room onto the artificial surface here, including Joe Montana, number 16. Joe Montana, as a starting quarterback in the city of New Orleans, is 6-0. He was not the quarterback for the 49ers when they visited the Dome this year. In fact, he was out because of an injured elbow, and Steve Young was the quarterback of the 49ers. Now, let's go downstairs to Irv Gross, who's standing by with the owner of the Denver Broncos. Irv?
Thanks, Brent. You know, Pat, you've gotten an awful lot of notoriety in the last few weeks with some controversial statements you've made about New Orleans and San Francisco. How were you received here in New Orleans?
Well, we've had a wonderful week here in New Orleans, and you know, the statement about New Orleans was really taken out of context. What I said was that the Super Bowl is no place for children, and because there aren't anything for children to do, and somehow that got turned around that I said New Orleans is no place for children, which is, you know, I didn't say that.
Yeah. Well, Pat, I saw the players out here yesterday, and you were with them on the field as they were inspecting the field, and Dan Reese pointed up to the banners around the stadium and reacted. What was all that about?
Well, you know, one of the banners, or the last one, is there for this year's Super Bowl, and it has the 49ers helmet on the left and the Broncos on the right. And all the rest of them, the Broncos, or the losers, rather, helmet is on the right. And so they've already sort of projected us as the loser as far as we see it.
But, Pat, you're sort of an on-hands owner. You're with the team practically every day. Have you talked to this club about the game and what it means to this really?
We're very up for this game. How could you not be? I mean, we can create history here. I mean, the media and the whole country has really made us a decided underdog. We can go the way that the Jets did in 69 or the Kansas City did in 1970. And there are not very many opportunities that come along like that. And so we're real excited. You know, I said earlier that we're going to win this game. I believe we're going to win this game. If I didn't believe we were going to win this game, I wouldn't be here.
Well,
so I do think it's going to be an upset if we lose.
Pat, thanks for being with us. And who else would expect the Broncos to win except the owner of the Broncos? Thanks for being with us, Pat. Let's go to Will McDonough.
Thanks very much, Irv. You know, late in the season, Joe Montana went into Anaheim to play a big game against the Rams. When he was on the field warming up, he heard the theme song for Monday Night Football, started to sing along with it, and liked it. He had a great game that night. He threw two touchdown passes over 90 yards to John Taylor and decided maybe it was good luck. So he asked his friend Jim Warren to make a recording of it and put it in this cassette right here. Joe's carried around with him all week for inspiration. He figures it's good luck. When he's introduced here today to a run out in the field, get the game ball, come right behind me, and as soon as he starts to warm up, Jim Warren, his friend, will turn on the music loud so he can beat these speakers. And Joe certainly hopes that all his rowdy friends in the Niners show up here to play football today. Let's go back to Brent.
All right, well, somehow I can't envision the cool, calm Joe Montana screaming, "Are you ready for the football?" You know, the Denver Broncos have a great record against the 49ers in the 80s. They are 3-0. But keep in mind one thing about those three victories. On each occasion, the Broncos in the 80s have had to come from behind to beat them. All right, still ahead of us now on the Super Bowl today, we're going to take a video odyssey with Mark Jackson, the Bronco wide receiver, who will give us a rare off-the-field glimpse of his teammates as they get ready for today's Super Bowl. And the last time a Super Bowl was played here in the Superdome, Chicago Bear coach Mike Ditka rode off a winner. Iron Mike is going to join us as our special guest analyst. And coming up next, we'll take you into television's inner sanctum, the trucks, where they decide what you see on your screen.
Guys,
stay tuned.
Let's do this.
Yesterday, the defense really made me look bad. So now, no uniform, just my favorite Hanes sweats. After a day of eating mud, nothing feels better than the comfort of Hanes. They let me look sharp, even in the face of my toughest competitors.
Now you're wearing what you like.
You know the sinking feeling of a dead battery.
Mommy, what's wrong?
Just stay in the car.
Now there's the revolutionary Diehard Dual Start. It's two Diehard batteries in one. A simple twist taps at the built-in spare Diehard, so you're not left stranded.
Mom, you fixed it.
It's cutting-edge technology, and it's Diehard. Diehard Dual Start. More power when you need it most.
There is no sound so unique as the human voice. Soon, it will bring you voice-activated calling on the all-fiber optic network of U.S. Sprint.
Chris Stanford.
A system that recognizes your voice.
Call home.
And dials numbers.
Hello, darling.
Just by asking. Such is the power of the human voice. The new voice-activated calling card. Only from U.S. Sprint.
Welcome back to New Orleans. Bourbon Street and the Big Easy may be the place to be for fans and for those players who earlier in the week succumbed to its temptations. But to the coaches, it's just one of the many distractions that seem to interfere with the preparations for the Super Bowl. There is the unaccustomed extra week that throws off the normal rhythm. There's also the microscopic scrutiny of 2,400 members of the media representing 18 different countries who have turned the press box into a journalistic United Nations. Now, by far the biggest distraction this week was a story that broke on a Washington TV station this week alleging a cover-up on the part of the NFL with regard to its already controversial drug testing program. So players on the two teams suddenly found themselves answering questions. NFL Commissioner Paul Tagliabue, while vehemently denying the story, did, however, say there were some aspects of the league's drug testing policy that needed to be reviewed, and the commissioner said that banning steroids will be a major priority. Now, speaking of preparations, we at CBS have been getting ready to telecast Super Bowl 24 for over a year. And as the crew goes through its final technical checks, Dick Butkus is down inside the control room. Dick?
Well, Brent, this is not the inside of a spaceship. This is the control room where these guys bring you the broadcast. Now, there's over 40 miles of cable, 15 cameras for the game. There's 10 videotape machines. There's 2 super slow-mos. There's the guys up here control, make all the controls to the one camera in the helicopter. There's also a camera in a blimp. Now, I hope them guys up there in a blimp know that we're playing the game in a dome. And to run all this is over 100 technicians. Now, since I'm down here in the control room, why don't I send you to Pat and John?
That's a good switch from Dick Butkus. Actually, John and I have been here for 10 days, but the integral part of our preparation, I think, is that we try to stay so close to the teams. We've seen them both practice. And John, in the case of the Broncos, I think their main concern would be Bobby Humphrey.
Well, you know, we were at the Bronco practice on Wednesday, and Bobby Humphrey really looked good. I mean, he was moving well. He was starting. He was taking most of the reps with the offense. But as Dan Reeves said, and Bobby Humphrey said, too, that I can do all these things. I can run. He had a little trouble getting his hands up to catch a ball. But as I say, what's going to happen the first time Ronnie Lott hits him?
Well, and the other concern, I suppose, would have to be the condition of their tight end, Clarence Kay.
Yeah, and he didn't look very good. He just couldn't get that leg loosened up. He couldn't do it on Wednesday. We watched him out here yesterday, and he still didn't look like he had confidence that he could play. And Dan Reeves said it's getting to be a mental thing because with a leg, you have to be ready to go. If he can't play, that's going to affect the Bronco running game.
Certainly will indeed. As far as the 49ers are concerned, the flu bug bit Roger Craig. It also got Guy McIntyre. They both missed a day of practice. But their main concern, I think, has to be Ronnie Lott.
Well, of course, they're concerned a little with Roger Craig, too, because in that thing, he weighed 214 pounds. He went down. Yesterday, we talked to him. He weighed 205 pounds, so he's lost 9 pounds. And as he said, he feels good. He feels quick, but you wonder if he's going to be strong in that second half. And then as far as Ronnie Lott, he injured his leg in the championship game. And he really hasn't run since. We were out at practice, and he would stand out there, and he didn't even try and run. We were out at practice yesterday. He didn't try and run. He said the first time he's going to try will be in a game today.
Well, one thing I can tell you, we're ready. Let's go back to Brent.
All right, Pat, thank you. And so are they ready over here in the Nippon Television booth going back to Tokyo. Yeah. This is the Pat Summerall of Japanese television. Tako Masuda.
I lay the play-by-play.
Ah, now, is American football big now in Tokyo, growing?
Yes, very famous and very popular sport in Japan. Okay, I heard you can understand Japanese. May I speak Japanese?
Sure, I'll try.
Okay. American ball では5万枚のチケットがわずか3時間で売り切れました。
Oh, that many people showed up. Now listen, we've got a play from a San Francisco 49er game, a touchdown pass. Let's listen first as our colleague Pat Summerall described what happened.
Okay.
First down. Back to the 18. Montana. For the bucket. To Taylor. Touchdown.
All right, Taco, now, how would that touchdown have sounded in Tokyo?
Touchdown is a touchdown. ボールオン18ヤード、ロジャー・クレイグ、インモーション、モンタナ、ドロップバック、オーバーザ・ミドル、エンドゾーンに投げた、タッチダウン、タッチダウンパスキャッチ、ジョン・テイラ
ー That is very good, huh? You got a standing ovation in the broadcast.
Touchdown.
And we're going to continue live from the Superdome in just a moment.
The Super Bowl today, live from New Orleans, is sponsored by Clear Light Diet Sprite with a great taste of Lyman when you want a change. The Die Hard Battery, now with more power when you need it most. And by Chrysler Corporation, the car company with a guaranteed rebate on most new 1990 cars and trucks.
Now boarding track number.
Isn't this great?
I changed my mind.
What?
Changed your mind?
Changed your mind.
When you want to change, there's only one diet soft drink with the great taste of Lyman.
Mind about me. How could I be so blind?
Oh, you change your mind about your hair.
Clear Light Diet Sprite. When you want to change.
I like it. It's different.
Here at the firehouse, we always try to sit down and eat a good square meal. But to be honest, we just can't always do it. Sure, we know we still need to get stuff like vitamins, minerals, and nutrients. And we do, at breakfast, in Product 19.
No one food has everything you need, but every Product 19 breakfast has 19 vitamins, minerals, and other essential nutrients. So if you can't always count on eating right.
Lunch? Yeah, maybe tomorrow.
Count on 19. Product 19.
500 miles of the hottest wheels on earth. Fasten your seatbelts when CBS Sports puts you behind the wheel in the Daytona 500.
You can just imagine now some of the thoughts that John Elway is experiencing at this moment. He's an hour away from kickoff, and Elway and Dan Reeves, his coach, so badly want to win their first Super Bowl championship. Reeves, in fact, has really run a very tight ship this week in New Orleans, and he is hopeful that his rookie running back sensation, Bobby Humphrey, will be able to bear up. Those two cracked ribs are very high on the right side. A special pad, but you know, when he carries the ball with that padding, as Hank Stram was telling us, that ball is apt to be outside, and perhaps the 49ers will be trying to jar it loose as the players are now out on the field for their final preparations here leading up to Super Bowl 24. And there is Jerry Rice, the man who can turn a 5-yard pass into a 90-yard touchdown. Joe Montana, who leads him just perfectly. When you think about it, just remember how catchable Montana's passes are. Well, in practice right now, he has been taught to throw the football right between the receiver's eyes. That's what Coach Bill Walsh wanted him to do, get him used to it. And now it is George Seifert who has replaced Walsh as the head coach. He's trying to become only the second rookie head coach to win a Super Bowl championship. The other was Don McCafferty, the late Don McCafferty of the Baltimore Colts. And now George Seifert, obviously, expressing and telling his assistants exactly how he wants to handle the situation. The big task of his defense will be keeping John Elway contained, not letting him get outside, scramble for big gains. He uses the shotgun formation probably more than any quarterback in the game today. And meanwhile, Roger Craig and Jerry Rice and the rest of the 49ers will try to put as many points as they can up on the board here this afternoon and give the Broncos something to shoot at. And the crowd continuing to file on into the Superdome, the world's largest indoor arena. You could take the Houston Astrodome and you could put it inside the Louisiana Superdome. That's how vast this building is, and a beautiful overall look at it now. And you know, the players and the coaches are not the only ones who've been busy preparing for today's Super Bowl. Bernard Goldberg, chief correspondent for CBS News 48 Hours, has been following a pair of behind-the-scenes stories about other preparations.
Party animals are everywhere. The fact is, there are a few things that cast a spell over America the way a Super Bowl does.
Hey, mama, don't treat me wrong. Come love that all night long. Hey,
and here in New Orleans, there are a few things that cast a spell over a Super Bowl the way that Kenneth does.
Onituni baba wa yami. Onituni baba wa yami.
Kenneth is the Reverend Kenneth, voodoo practitioner, who says...
Someone essentially is, in a spiritual sense, trying to throw the game. A powerful negative energy force had been directed against the San Francisco team.
So the Reverend Kenneth is preparing a talisman, a good luck charm, a football in this case, to ward off the evil hex placed on Joe Montana and the 49ers by someone in the Colorado area.
It's called Wanga Wanga. It's very... very powerful root that has been ground up.
So this is the old Wanga Wanga root going into the back.
That's correct. Itakwe pasa ma veri punchango. Itakwe pasa ma veri punchango.
Has anyone ever called you goofy?
Talk about goofy. John and Terry are Denver fans who've come to the Super Bowl because they love their Broncos without reservations. In fact, they have no reservation.
You got a hotel, a great hotel, I guess, right?
We have no hotel.
No hotel.
We have no tickets.
No room, no tickets, no way, Jose, you might be thinking.
I can't wait to find out how this turns out.
Me neither. Where are we going?
First stop, the French Quarter, to search for an old friend.
Bam. Gotta see Bam. Gotta see if Bam's around.
Who just may know somebody who just may have a room.
Tickets?
Cheap.
Anybody got tickets?
This is Tropical Isle. We're asking for Pam.
Yeah.
Let's find the manager.
This is a nice place. Sonata. We're going on anyway.
What the hell we find a place to stay? Deja vu. Is Pam here?
Decatur? Ah, this must be the place.
Good.
Uh-oh.
Okay, so they found Pam.
There she is!
But what about the room?
Hey, hey, hello, how are ya?
Pretty good, how about yourself?
Amari, we ask you, sweet mother, to bless this.
And the Reverend Kenneth has also made a contact.
The spell which has been placed against this team unjustly.
Because this is a super hex, he wants to consult with New Orleans' number one voodoo queen, Marie Laveau. Did I mention she's been dead for 93 years?
We refresh this talisman with rum.
I'm moved, Reverend Ken, by the... solemnity of the religious experience, especially when you spit the Bacardi out on the football.
Mm. That's my favorite part, too.
You gonna put us up?
We can put you up.
This is perfect.
Where's the bed?
Yeah, you're looking at it. Where's the blue bed, with the one with the blue sheets. Yeah.
Oh, you gotta stand in one place when you shower, though. Look at this.
What are you talking about?
In a whole roll of toilet paper, we're golden.
We have room.
We've achieved roomage.
The Reverend Kenneth, meanwhile, is on his way to the Superdome.
Well, now we'll take it and we'll present it to the gentleman for whom it is intended, the owner of the 49ers.
Yes, I'm Reverend Kenneth from Marie Laveau's House of Voodoo, and I need to present this to Mr. DiBartolo.
You have to check with the desk, the blue desk on the side, the NFL desk, maybe there'll be other papers.
Thank you.
Day two of our 48 hours, 3 in the afternoon. A major breakthrough.
Oh, Terry.
John thinks he may have found tickets.
It's ticket time.
Terry is underwhelmed.
You look like you've been up all night.
Dude, I can get the tickets for us? You don't mind where they're at? Can I have your money? more, but if your friends are dentists, you can have them from you.
Section 609 is nosebleed.
I don't know. Yeah, but it's, you know, it's getting into the game that counts.
So now I got to ask you the TV question. How do you feel?
Great. We got rooms. We got an airfare home. I got money left, and I'm going to the game.
Meanwhile, the Reverend Kenneth, who had no trouble talking to a dead woman, can't figure out how to get the football across town to the 49ers. So he decides to leave it on his voodoo altar. The hex against Joe Montana and the 49ers, he says, has been removed.
Oh, Terry! We made it!
Super Bowl? Sunday? Did you wait by then?
Yep.
Sweet dreams, buddy. Pick you up for dinner?
Mm-hmm. Bye, dear.
It's magic, isn't it?
I'm going to Super Bowl.
At last check, our two fans had traded up to Section 339, but they are still working on deals outside the Superdome. As for Joe Montana, he's extremely happy to learn that that hex has been removed.
What hex? Says John Elway.
And meanwhile, Joe Montana will try to win his fourth Super Bowl, and a man who won his first right here just a couple of years ago, the Iron Man himself, Mike Ditka, will be with us live when we continue in just a moment.
You know, today car prices are like a yo-yo, up one day, down the next. And maybe it's our fault. Chrysler invented the rebate, and the car business hasn't been the same since. Even I'm a little confused. That's why we introduced the guaranteed rebate. If our rebate goes up during this model year, we'll pay you the difference. And you must like it. Chrysler's having the biggest January in its history. So, we're extending the guaranteed rebate until February 28th on every car, pickup, and Jeep we build. And on top of that, we'll pay you $50 to test drive our products against anybody else's. Whether you buy ours or theirs, you win either way. But you know, rebates, guarantees, test drives aside, maybe the best thing I've ever done for you is put a driver's side airbag in every car we build in the U.S. Now that's a difference you can live with, and so can I.
Whiskas. It's no ordinary cat food. It's the cat food cats find irresistible. Whether it's meaty or crunchy, it's got the fresh meat taste cats just adore. As you see, cats know what's good. That's why more and more cat owners tell us their cats prefer Whiskas.
Ago at this time, I introduced you to the tragic story of Mike Helms. He was a collegiate star with plenty of promise.
And Helms is a great shooter.
But his career path was blocked by drugs. Today, Mike Helms is finished serving his time. 5 years behind bars at this correctional facility. Now, with the support of his family, he is quietly making the difficult transition back into society.
Staying clean is the toughest thing I've ever done. But I'm going to make it. And I'm going to try to reach out to the young people and help them avoid the same pitfalls that I have.
Hard-headedness cost Lynn Bonds his life. Cost just the man that he's...
Given another shot, Mike Helms is staging one of the greatest comebacks the game has ever seen.
Where there's help, there's hope.
The Dixieland beat continues from Preservation Hall as we close in on Super Bowl 24 between the 49ers and the Broncos. And we welcome a coach who won that trophy here in New Orleans just a few years ago, Mike Ditka. Mike, what's the feeling now that's going through the minds and stomachs of the coaches and the players?
I think the main feeling right now is anticipation. There's no fear, and the other feelings really don't matter. It's you can't wait to get going. And that's what's going through everybody down on that field. And coaches, they can't wait to get going. They want to see if all the strategies, all the things they've worked on through the whole season and through the last couple of weeks are ready to work.
Were you confident on that day against New England?
Never had a doubt in my mind that the Bears would win. And then I think that was the one thing with our whole football team, even though there were some distractions that week, we never had a question in our mind. And I think the reason for that, Brent, not to be egotistical or the fact that we thought we were a better team, is that our defense had played so well in the playoffs with two shutouts, and that's why we were so confident going in.
Mike, did you care who the referee or know who he was before the game started?
Well, I knew who he was, but did I care? No, they're all good. I never met a bad one.
You know what's interesting about this game, Mike, is that the league made the referee available for an interview prior to the game for the first time. And Will McDonough spoke to Dick Jorgensen yesterday.
Dick, has it gotten to you yet that maybe the fear, the anticipation of refereeing your first Super Bowl game?
No, sir, not really any fear. Certainly worked a lot of games in the National Football League, so thrilled to be here, but there's no fear at all.
Listen, what is it like for this game? Is it any different in terms of preparation for you and your crew?
No, we prepare for this game just like we prepare for a preseason game or a regular season game. We have a little bit more time since we're in a couple days early, and we go over every detail, but we look at the mechanics and how we're going to cover the field, and the cooperation and communication among the crew. So, in essence, the preparation is the same, except it's a little bit longer.
Now, this is an all-star crew. I think people should know that really the best in the NFL is here today. You're graded during the year, but perhaps you haven't worked with some of these guys before. How do you work that out so you can get along together?
We spend a lot of time in pregame conferences talking about the mechanics of coverage and how each of us will react to different situations. That's how we prepare. Our mechanics are the same all year among all the different crews, and we go over and over and over those, so after the first couple of plays, we'll be right in sync with each other.
Seven officials and two of them, the head linesman, Ernie France, and the line judge, Ron Bloom, did work together on the same crew during the regular season. So a lot of pressure on the officials in a game such as this one. They go over the last-minute preparations down there. And, you know, Mike, one of the great matchups of this game really will be the Broncos safeties and the two gentlemen who will have to take on the 49er wide receivers. And Dennis Smith had this conversation today with Irv Cross.
Dennis, throughout the playoffs, 49ers have been red hot. Nobody's been able to stop their offense. How are you guys going to do it?
Well, I don't think anybody can just absolutely stop the offense when they're rolling, but we got to do our best to contain them and not give them, try our best to keep them out of the end zone. I think that's the key. If we can hold them to a few points under their average, they've been averaging like 30 points a game, and if we can stay in this game to the fourth quarter, we'll find a way to win it.
How do you prevent those short, quick passes, those 5-, 6-, 7-, 8-yard passes from turning into 92-yard touchdowns?
I think you got to, you can't overly give them too much respect. You got to challenge them a little bit more, and when they catch the ball, make sure you're close enough to them that you can make the tackle before they have the time to put a move on you. Hopefully, if we can do that, get some hits on them, we'll cause some turnovers, and that's what we like to do, cause turnovers, make things happen. That's what we expect to happen.
Dennis, I hope you can put your finger on this one for me, but the Broncos have had an awful lot of success against the 49ers under Dan Reese. He's never lost to them in the regular season. Why is that, you know?
Well, even in those games, like I said, they've had success moving the ball, but they haven't been able to score very many points on us. And I expect that to be the, I expect that to happen today. I expect them, they're going to have some success. We can't get out our game plan, just stay, keep our composure. And I think that's going to be the biggest thing. We got, if we keep them out of the end zone, you'll see the same type of game.
All right, Dennis and Ronnie Lott were very close friends at USC. Lott has won some championships, and now Dennis says it's his turn. Well, the section of the country that has produced some of the greatest football players ever, including Joe Montana and Mike Ditka, is Pennsylvania, Monongahela. And we're going to check in live in Joe Montana's country in just a moment.
It was one of the boldest assassination plots in history.
Hitler must be killed.
Now the truth can be told. Brad Davis, Madeline Smith, The Plot to Kill Hitler, Tuesday.
This is CBS.
The Hyundai Excel has been the best-selling imported car for 3 years running. How can you beat that? Introducing the all-new 1990 Hyundai Excel. It has 20% more horsepower, more room inside, and a more aerodynamic outside. The all-new Excel. We're sorry to see the old one go, but there's only so much room at the top. Hyundai, we're making more sense than ever. Now, save up to $2,000 with factory cash back and factory to dealer incentives.
Now, here's my idea of a smart little business. Smart people, growing sales, they got everything except their own phone system. And that's smart, too. No switching equipment in their office, nothing to maintain. Their system's called Centrix. It's a Pacific Belt. They maintain it. They expand it as your business grows. All you have to do is call Pacific Bell and say, plug me in. Pacific Bell, we're making things easier.
Those April showers.
Dinner with Amanda. You remember that? Conference in Colorado? Ah, yes. You used to hate April. Taxes, sorting through receipts. But as a Gold Card member, you get this year-end summary of charges. Itemized, civilized, far less taxing.
Whenever April showers come along.
The American Express. Gold Card.
Iron Eagle. Sunday after Grand Slam.
A glimpse at the Crescent City scene from the MetLife blimp. And that's one of the world's largest airships, measuring 194 feet long and giving you that spectacular view of the skyline of New Orleans. And inside, the San Francisco 49ers, concluding their pregame warm-ups, will now go back inside their locker room. Those final tense moments prior to the start of a Super Bowl, as they try to become the first team to back up Super Bowl championships since the great Pittsburgh Steelers teams. Hoping that when this game concludes, they'll be filing back in there to again receive the Vince Lombardi trophy. The Denver Broncos staying on the field. One of the plays you will not see down there by the goal line, according to Coach Reeves, is the option play with Dan Reeves, saying that Elway really is not an option quarterback. You folks might remember in the Cleveland game when he tried the option and it wound up being a fumble recovered by the Browns. He said, I never should have called that play down there. Mike, Monongahela, how far did you grow up from there? Where was your hometown?
Not very far. Monongahela is in western Pennsylvania also, but it's a little bit out of Pittsburgh, the other direction than Aliquippa is. So we're not very far away, but I'm very accustomed to that area. When I was a youngster, very youngster, we played a little baseball against Monongahela. At that time, they were I think they won one of the first Little League World Series games. I know Freddie Cox, a great kicker with Minnesota for years, and he went to Pitt with me. He was from Monongahela, so they had a lot of good athletes out of that area.
Would it shock you if I told you that it was snowing in that part of the world today?
Nothing shocks me about that Monongahela or Chicago.
Well, let's check it. Where is Pat O'Brien? Pat, where are you?
Brent, we are doing what millions of Americans are doing. We're driving to a Super Bowl party. About that snow, Brent and Mike, they say out here in western Pennsylvania that when it snows on game day, Joe Montana wins. So they're looking for that. 49er fans should be happy about that. We're not cheap. We're bringing our own pizzas to the party. This, as you said, Brent, is the home area of Joe Montana. A lot of memories. All everywhere you look here, they say Montana did this, Montana did that. In fact, right over there in that field is where Joe Montana used to play baseball. Of course, Little Joey, as they called him, ended up a football player. And we spent the week kind of driving around the town to show you some of the places that Joe remembers. If you think we made Joe Montana look like an angel up there, what do you see what the people in here think of him? These are all cousins. Hello, ladies, gentlemen.
Hi.
How are you? How's it going? Brought the pizzas. Inside the house here in Monongahela, this is a cousin mayor. This is the mayor of Monongahela. We're pronouncing it right, right? As we drive around the city, Mayor, how come there's no street named after Joe Montana?
Well, one time we thought about it, but you know there is a state called Montana.
You're not going to tell me that, huh?
Oh, sure I am.
Mayor, thanks for something. Take the pizzas, pass them around. How you doing, folks? They're eating sausage. Mike Ditko will look at this and pray for some of this sausage out here. Patty is our hostess, who didn't know that she'd be hosting the country here.
No, I didn't.
Patty, how many cousins did Joe have?
Oh, there's well over 100.
100. 100. Some people don't know 100 people.
I know, but we have a big family.
What kind of a kid was Joe Montana growing up?
Joe was, he was like a good kid, but him and my brother always found some trouble to get into.
Nothing controversial that we should know about.
No, I don't think so.
Nothing on game day. Patty, thanks. Enjoy it. See you, folks. Back in here, we got folks. You think it's going to be a close game today, folks? Yeah, they know. Anyway, here's the cake that our crew has tried to eat, but we saved it this long, and we're going to probably, they want to celebrate after the game. They've been celebrating Montana Mania around here for decades, two decades. And Montana, of course, Joe became a star football player in Midget League, and this is his Midget League coach, Carl Crawley. And Carl, what did you recognize in Joe at the age of 9 or 10?
Oh, he had the ability to run to his left and throw the ball with authority and really pinpoint the pass at a very early age of 10 years old.
You take credit for that running to the left, throwing to the right stuff?
No, I just take credit for utilizing it. Yeah. Like everybody else, you know, along the line, the kid had the ability. All we did was utilize it.
You always trusted him, great leadership qualities, even at that age, at 9 years old? Or is this just hindsight, you thought?
No, at that early age, he was able to call the play. He knew how the play worked, and he was able to tell his other ball players what they had to do on the play. This was the heady ball player he was.
Coach, enjoy the game. You know, I'm not going to forget about the tree, okay? Because there's still other Christmas tree up here, and it's loaded with Joe Montana memorabilia. And I don't even think they know this, though. Patty, did you know this? This baseball card right here, this football card, is his rookie card, 1981, which is worth $200. No, I wouldn't like to buy it. And they have two of them on there. Of course, they have kids sitting around here. They've been around here watching television all day. Cody, do your kids at school believe you when you tell them that you're Joe Montana's cousin?
Yes.
Yeah? Who do you like in the game today?
Joe.
You like Joe in the game. Okay. So that's it from Monica Hala. We've been having a great time here. Coach, get him quiet. Hey, Brent, Mike, watch this. Hey, folks, if Joe Montana wasn't playing, who here's a Steeler fan? Yeah! Don't tell Joe. Get back to you guys.
We promised that too, Pat. Thank you very much. Mike, what is it that makes Joe so effective in the National Football League? You've tried to defend it.
Well, I think what you've got to understand is what all the quarterbacks said earlier today, Brent, and there's a lot of qualities, intelligence, athletic ability. But I tell you what, he's in the best offense for Joe Montana. It's a rhythm offense. He gets rid of the ball in 1-2-3 or 1-2-3-4-5. There's no mess around. He knows what to do in every situation. I think if you look at the way he runs with the football, he knows when to run, how far to run, when to get on the ground, when to get out of bounds, when to throw the ball away. He's a heady quarterback. He doesn't make too many mistakes. And people who have tried to blitz him have really had no success.
You know, Wade Phillips, the defensive coordinator for the Broncos, who's done such a good job, he was telling some reporters earlier in the week, Mike, that he's going to try to force Joe back to the left, perhaps easier said than done. Did you try that against him?
Well, you don't want him to go to his right. That's the main thing. That's where he's really good. Now, if you make him go to his left, not that he can't do it, but it's very hard for a quarterback to do that. I think what they're going to do, they're going to play some soft double zone. They're going to play some soft double zone, but not soft enough that they're not close to the receivers, so that if they do catch the ball, they've got to be in a position to tackle them, because a lot of the big plays that the 49ers make, they make because they make people miss tackles, and with Taylor and Rice, they just run away from people.
Okay, I want to talk about the Denver Broncos with you when we come back, but just a moment ago, the Broncos leaving the field here in New Orleans and filing back inside their locker room, and of course, they will be out here for their third Super Bowl of the decade. And when we come back, you will see the video prepared by Mark Jackson. He'll take you behind the scenes with the Broncos in this week of their preparation when we continue.
Dry was hot. Dry is Michelob Dry. Bold taste with absolutely no aftertaste. So it refreshes completely. One taste and you'll drink it dry.
My dream car would be a truck. A Nissan Hardbody. I'd race in Baja. Whoa, wait a minute. Time out. Make that the mountains. With nobody around except my girlfriend. And a pizza. And my boss. Somebody's got to wash the truck.
Paris, they lined up in the streets. In Rome, it was standing room only. In L.A. and New York, his concert sold out in an hour. So if you want to see Paul McCartney and his new band, get in line early and get out your Visa card. Because a concert like this doesn't take place every day, and it doesn't take American Express. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
Well, the riverboat Natchez tying up just prior to the Superdome here in New Orleans. Just been handed a fact that nachos, 7,232 will be sold here today, and popcorn, 16,157 boxes. Got some hungry folks. And if Mark Jackson of the Broncos ever wants out of football, he ought to consider a career in cinematography. Mark spent the week working with us, keeping a video diary that turned out very uplifting, if nothing else.
Hi, I'm Mark Jackson of the Denver Broncos. And in just a while, right below my feet, my football career will reach its ultimate peak, Super Bowl 24. But that's down there on the field. You may be asking yourself, why am I on top of the Superdome? Well, for the past 2 weeks, I've been sky high.
Open the door, baby. I'm going to New Orleans for the Super Bowl. My boys come out in style. Bill Brad, cooling in the limo.
Yeah, that's the baby that's going to take us there.
Hey, look at this.
How are you doing?
How festive. Hey, Coop, you really did have a hard night.
The Broncos have landed.
I knew I should have paid those traffic tickets.
Super Bowl 23.
Just looking at your body, I would think maybe you have taken the last couple weeks off.
I ain't saying nothing, man. My actions speak.
What that easy tape, man. Ain't anything else anymore?
Oh, yeah.
We're going to zoom in on that. Is that a... No, that is not a bicep, folks.
25, 25 inch?
That is a peanut.
Yo, Bobby, you've been there 10 minutes. Is it soup yet? Get it right, baby. This is a Super Bowl.
What are they doing to our quarterback? Putting wires and stuff on. None of these guys got a podium. They're hating it. They're all jealous. The man, the myth, the legend, Devin Wilder. Why don't you have a podium? That's what I want to know.
This is a podium.
Dennis, he's being interviewed by a Mexican station. He doesn't know any Mexican. But I do. I know what he's saying. He's saying Dennis Smith, the biggest hot dog of the Super Bowl.
I'm Mark Jackson of the Denver Broncos. Nice to meet you. Oh, he's got the ladies back there.
Hi.
How you doing?
Okay, ladies.
There's the boss. I'm just an impersonator. John, what do you think? What do you think about the game?
You're on the other side of the camera.
What I want to know is why didn't I make all Madden team?
If I can get open, they ought to throw me the ball more. I don't know why I don't have more catches.
What do you think, Moose? Is it good? Good stuff? Don't talk with your mouth open.
Nah, we'll pass on that one.
Hey, watch those guys. They might be putting something in their pockets over there. That's why I've got the camera.
Good morning, Mr. Jackson. This is your wake-up call. It's Super Bowl Sunday.
Oh, is it really?
Yeah, I don't imagine they're that loose inside that locker room right now, Mike.
Like I said, it's anticipation. I don't think they're that tight. It's going to go away in a hurry because I think they've been looking forward. You know, the long wait is something, and they just want to get out there and get it. The juices are flowing.
All right, and everybody's juices are starting to flow here in the Superdome, and prior to the start of this game, well, they've got a show that reminds you of the Mardi Gras. In fact, that's the theme here in the pregame show. Cast of 1,000. Saints quarterback Archie Manning, a former star here, the king of Mardi Gras. One of the leaders down there on the field. And we'll continue live from New Orleans in just a moment.
Mother Nature left us.
Plastic.
Yeah, I'll bet Mother Nature didn't leave this.
You're right, but plastics can be recycled into things like that bench or even fiberfill for vests like yours.
So plastics can be recycled.
Smart companies are working on lots of ways to make good use of stuff like this.
Yeah, like who?
When you've got your Power Stroke going, nothing's gonna beat you. Introducing Power Stick Antiperspirant. 24-hour protection in just one wide stroke. New Power Stick from Fabergé.
With the change in the air, the chills, they don't stop. Feeling the cold of the temperature drop.
Diet 7-Up with NutraSweet. Even more 7-Up taste in an icy new can.
The new taste of cold alone break the ice.
It's Valerie Harper, back where she belongs on Monday nights. She's a big city executive caught between dwindling dollars...
Someone will die.
...bull-headed bureaucrats...
As deputy mayor, I am in charge.
No, you're not.
What's it to you?
...and a less-than-helpful staff.
Ken, I want you naked on the desk.
Valerie Harper in City, premiering Monday after Major Dad.
Someone's waiting just for you. Troubles by the riverside. Get your painted pony on the spinning wheel
David Clayton Thomas, a singer with the group Blood, Sweat, and Tears, entertaining the crowd here, leading up to the introduction of the players, and finally Super Bowl 24 between the 49ers and the Broncos. Well, Mike, who do you like to win this game?
Well, I think the rest of the country has already made their choice. I'm going to go with the Broncos, and I can go for a lot of reasons. Most people say it's sentimentality. It's my friend Dan Reeves. I got the greatest of respect for the 49ers, their organization, and their players. In one game, anybody can win. I'm picking the upset.
Now, why would you do that? I mean, what convinces you that the Broncos are going to... No one else that I've talked to.
You know why I can do that? I can do that because automatically I'm an expert. Now, I'm part of the media, and that gives me expert credentials. I'm no longer a coach. I don't know anything. I'm just a member of the media. Therefore, I become an expert instantaneously.
Low scoring or high scoring, Mike?
I don't know. I think the game's going to fall somewhere in the area. One team's going to be in the 20s, the other one's in the teens. That's my feeling.
So you think John Elway's going to have a big game here this afternoon?
I said that they're going to win the game. I didn't say it was Elway's job to win the game. They got to win the game as a team. They got to play defense. They got to run the football.
I'm going to find a 49er fan. I'm going to find out where Dick Butkus is. And we'll do that, and we'll come back in just a moment.
Football.
Bo knows baseball.
Bo knows basketball, too.
Bo knows tennis?
No.
Bo knows weights.
Bo, you don't know diddly.
Put a luggage cart and a suitcase, and what do you get? Samsonite's Piggyback. It's particularly handy on long trips like the one from your car to the ticket counter.
The cold of an icicle feels so nice as it tickles your tongue with a teaspoon taste.
Now Diet 7-Up with NutraSweet's got more 7-Up taste in an icy new can.
The new taste of cold. Go on, break the ice.
Well, we've got an opportunity to check in around the stadium, and Will McDonough has been with the San Francisco 49ers all week. Will, what's new?
Well, Brent, I tell you, down here in the field, it's chaos right now, but what the Niners were talking about all during the pregame period is what will Denver do the first time they have the ball. The owner, Eddie DeBartolo, speculated shotgun with John Elway. The players were all talking about watch for the run and shoot. The big theme for the defense of the 49ers, Ronnie Lott was telling the players all through the workout, we got to be ready for everything. Well, now let's go upstairs and see if Pat and John are ready for the game. Pat?
All right, before we do that, Will, hold on, because we want to check in with Irv Cross, because he's got something on the Broncos before we go upstairs. Irv?
Brent, just a couple of personnel notes. First of all, Dan Reeves just told us that tight end Clarence Kay will not start, but will play. Instead, Orson Mobley gets the starting call. When you talk about attitude and feeling down here about overall player thoughts, the best way to put things is that most of the Broncos players have said, hey, look, we've been quiet all week. People have been putting us down, but now we have the chance to prove what we're made of. Brent?
All right, Irv, so even without Clarence Kay, and that's, you're okay, Mike, you're going to go with the Broncos?
Well, you know, there's teams in the league that don't even carry tight ends on their roster. I mean, Clarence Kay is a pretty
come
good
on,
one.
Dick,
on.
Can you believe what he's doing?
I almost stumbled coming in here when I said, when he said he's going to pick the Denver Broncos. I mean, I wonder if it could be the two playoff games he happened to lose to the 49ers. Oh. I wonder if there's a little something there.
Well, there could be, but then again, there might not be.
We'll see you at halftime, and we're going to send you to Pat and John when we continue live from New Orleans.
The Super Bowl today, live from New Orleans, has been sponsored by Nike, who reminds you to just do it. Diet 7-Up. Now more taste in an icy new can. Go on, break the ice. And by the American Express card. Membership has its privileges.
Tell a good bounty hunter by the size of his tool.
I brought a key.
That's not a key. This is a key.
Grand Slam after the Super Bowl.
This is CBS.
We got the dough. Toyota's got what you got, what you got, what you want. We got the dough.
People who know their trucks have more good times in Toyotas than any other small truck. And right now, you can get in on the action with super deals on every Toyota truck in the lineup. On most of them, save big on option packages, too. So come on.
Oh, we've got the show. Oh, the competition, yeah. We got the show.
This is a long way from downtown Chicago. Riding mass transit. Working late every night. You finally got the raise. That got you the gold card, that got you the phone number, that arranges your weekends wherever you want them. But you always want them in Montana. The American Express Gold Card.
When the West was young, getting a good beer wasn't easy.
Anybody want a Henry?
In fact, for the West's finest beer,
Henry Reinhardt,
beer drinkers would wait for months.
Just come into town.
It came from hundreds of miles away.
Oregon.
But if that seems like a lot of trouble just for a better beer.
Now for supper.
It really wasn't.
There's a few things not on the regular menu.
Because even then, Westerners did everything in a very special way.
We have a nice buffalo and a light cream sauce. Our fresh fish tonight is brook trout almondine. The desert sage hen is especially good. Rolled over mesquite.
Evening in New Orleans, tonight at 7.
Only
with the passage of time can true greatness be measured. But a yardstick for legends might be in order for the San Francisco 49ers. With surgical efficiency, they have reduced the playoffs to their own private clinic. And with an intensity reserved for champions, the 49ers have one final conquest within reach. A conquest that will forever secure their deserved place in history as a team of monumental achievement. Bearing the burden of untold promise and suffering the pain of past misfortune are the Denver Broncos, proud champions of the AFC, whose grit and perseverance have once again earned them a role in football's premier showcase. And with this bold challenge before them, the Broncos will need the prodigious talents of John Elway to wipe their slate clean and come away with that long-awaited Super Bowl championship. Entire careers are spent pursuing a dream, and today that dream is a reality in football's ultimate confrontation. The wonderful city of New Orleans in the background, and a magnificent arena, the Louisiana Superdome, the site of Super Bowl number 24. Weather conditions not a factor, not ever here. San Francisco and Denver, San Francisco trying to repeat, and the Broncos, who've lost three, trying to win their first one. We're live at the Louisiana Superdome. That's the 49er locker room. The officials just about ready to notify the 49ers that they have 2 minutes before they have to come out and get into action. And good afternoon. I hope it's a good one for you as it is for us. I'm Pat Summerall here with my colleague John Madden as usual. And John, you've been in that locker room situation in a game like this. What's going on and what's it like?
Well, you just want to get out. You just want to get out of that locker room and get on this field. Now, both teams have already been out here and had their pregame warm-up. Now they go back in there for 15 minutes. When the official knocks on the door, you have 2 minutes. So that's the time to call your team up and have final thoughts. George Seifert said he calls the team up and he talks about focus. We have to be focused in this one. And then he said, usually some emotional player will take over and give an emotional speech, usually someone like Ronnie Lott. Joe Montana says he's thinking of the first 15 plays. That's scripted. He's going over those plays. Then he starts to think of the first five. In those first five plays of this game today, Joe Montana wants to get the ball to Jerry Rice. Now, on the other side, on the Broncos side, Dan Reeves is in there. He said in the last 2 minutes, he takes over. And he just reminds them their goals, what they have to do offensively, what they have to do defensively, what they have to do on special teams. John Elway says he's trying to calm himself down because he said he is so emotional and he gets so high that he's afraid he'll just throw the ball out of the stadium. The thing that I've learned, I don't know that anyone even listens to anything anyone says anyway.
But I'll guarantee you they're emotional. In fact, both coaches said neither one of us is a Newt Rockne. We don't make emotional speeches, but they're up, believe me. Back with the player introductions in a moment.
The Russian disappeared. Invisible.
This thing could park a couple of hundred warheads off Washington and New York.
Stolen.
He's defecting. The Russians knew this, which is why they've been trying to see him for the past 2 days.
The hunt is on.
Now you want us to help you hunt him down and kill him?
Battle stations.
Give the man a chance.
From the director of Die Hard.
Torpedo is an acquisition.
From the best-selling novel by Tom Clancy.
We sail into history.
The Hunt for Red October. March 2nd.
Rubbermaid waste cans are built to withstand an accidental, an occasional, and still bounce back for more.
Perfect!
Don't you wish everything was made like Rubbermaid?
The
The Volvo 240 has built a reputation for surviving accidents. And we at Subaru have always been impressed by that. So we gave the new Subaru Legacy Wagon unibody construction, like the Volvo 240. But unlike the 240, the Subaru Legacy is available with full-time four-wheel drive and anti-lock brakes. Because the best way to survive an accident is not to get into one.
The Superdome in New Orleans, the site of Super Bowl number 24. And we're just about set. This is the ultimate. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome the champions of the National Football Conference, the San Francisco 49ers. The starting offense for the San Francisco 49ers. At 6 feet 1, 185, he caught the winning touchdown in last year's Super Bowl. And wide receiver from Delaware State, number 82, John Taylor. At 6'6 and 299, starting his second Super Bowl at left tackle from Michigan, number 77, Bubba Parris. At 6'3, 265, starting his second Super Bowl at left guard from Georgia, number 62, Guy McIntyre. At 6'4, 260, starting his second Super Bowl at center from Hawaii, number 61, Jesse Sipolu. Super Bowl start at right guard from Texas Arlington, number 69, Bruce Colley. At 6'4", 280, making his second Super Bowl start at right tackle from North Carolina, number 79, Harris Barton. Super Bowl start at tight end from Santa Clara, number 84, Brent Jones. At 6'2 and 200, the most valuable player in last year's Super Bowl, wide receiver from Mississippi Valley State, number 80, Jerry Rice. At 6'2, 195, a two-time Super Bowl most valuable player, the quarterback for Notre Dame, number 16, Joe Montana. At 6 feet, 214 pounds, he holds the single-game Super Bowl record for touchdowns with three in Super Bowl 19 at running back from Nebraska, number 33, Roger Craig. At 6'1", 232, he led all NFC running backs in receptions this year with 73. At running back from Nebraska, number 44, Tom Rathman. And the head coach with the most wins of any head coach in his first season, George Seifert. Broncos. the starting defense for the Denver Broncos. At 6'6 and 272, playing in his first Super Bowl at left end from Florida State, number 92, Alfonso Carriker. At 6'3 and 265, he'll be making his first Pro Bowl appearance at nose tackle from Utah State, number 71, Greg Cregan. At 6'4 and 265, he had a career high in quarterback sacks this year with 9. At right end from Washington, number 90, Ron Holmes. At 6'1, 235, making his first Super Bowl start at left outside linebacker from LSU, number 56, Michael Brooks. At the other linebacker for the Denver Broncos, Rick Dennison, number 55. At 6'3", 240, in the Pro Bowl this season for the fourth time in 5 years, and right inside linebacker for Minnesota, number 77, Carl Mecklenburg. At 6'5", 240, he led the Broncos in quarterback sacks this season with 12. At right outside linebacker from Houston, number 73, Simon Fletcher. He led the Broncos in interceptions this season with 6. Left cornerback from North Dakota State, number 34, Tyrone Braxton. At 5'10", 186, starting his first Super Bowl at right cornerback from Nevada, Las Vegas, number 24, Wyman Henderson. At 6'3", 3 inches, 200 pounds, he'll be making his third Pro Bowl appearance. The Broncos' defensive MVP this season and strong safety from the University of Southern California, number 49, Dennis Smith. At 6'3", 217 pounds, as a rookie, he led the Broncos in solo tackles this season. At free safety from Arkansas, number 27, Steve Atwater. And the head coach, making an NFL record 8th appearance in a Super Bowl as a player and a coach, Dan Reeves. Superdome coming up, as will the national anthem. We'll be back.
Rock and roll is okay, but I prefer rap.
Awesome.
Wait a second. Shady Acres was supposed to get the Coke, and the frat house was supposed to get the Pepsi.
Coke, Pepsi, what's the difference?
I-24.
This is radical.
In civilized society, any grooving lapse can result in a mortifying loss of station. But with Right Guard's push stick, one gets maximum protection. Well, off to the foxes. Right Guard's push stick. Anything less would be uncivilized.
Oh.
high blood pressure, and I don't know what his vital signs are. I don't know what he took.
The numbers are heartbreaking. Almost 2 million American teenagers use illicit drugs. More than a quarter of a million of them use cocaine or crack at least once a week. To appreciate the magnitude of these numbers, all you have to do is look at one. New medical evidence has shown that cocaine or crack can cause fatal heart seizures, even in first-time users. Remember, it's not a game, it's your life. Don't let it end in sudden death.
Where there's help, there's hope.
To honor America, here to perform our national anthem is New Orleans' own Grammy nominee, Aaron Neville. Is over. The hoopla will continue, and the game is coming up, led by the coin toss.
After a year of waiting, after months of hype, it's time to rock and roll. Later today on CBS.
Contact first made news in 1961. In 1976, the news was two Sudafed. Today, there's new Coadvil. Coadvil has what no other cold product has, the pain reliever in Advil plus a proven decongestant. A combination never available before in just one tablet. Coadvil is so effective it can relieve nasal congestion, sinus pressure, and the aches and pains of your cold, all without drowsiness. Read label before using. New Coadvil, advanced formula for cold and sinus relief.
Normally, folks in way out Homer, Alaska couldn't care less who wins the Super Bowl. Until this year. Because if the 49ers win, McDonald's will serve up their McDLT for just $1.09.
We're pulling for the Niners.
We have family in Tampa.
But if the Broncos win, it'll be a quarter pounder with cheese for only 99 cents.
I want a victory so bad I can taste it.
Would a sip of my Diet Coke help?
$1.09 McDLT or a 99-cent quarter pounder. May the hungriest team win.
We're football fans from way back.
Since yesterday.